प्रपन्नपारिजाताय तोत्र वेत्रैकपाणये ज्ञानमुद्राय कृष्णाय गीतामृतदुहे नमः. ओम नमो वेंकटेशाय. माय बेस्ट विशेस एंड परिपूर्ण आशीर्वादम्स टू ऑल द व्यूवर्स ऑफ श्री वेंकटेश्वर भक्ति चैनल. मे द ऑलमाइटी श्री लॉर्ड वेंकटेश्वर बिस्टो ऑल काइंड्स ऑफ प्रॉस्पेरिटी हेल्थ वेल्थ एंड इटर्नल हैप्पीनेस with paripurna lakshmi kataksham's to you and entire your family members and your friends. Today we are about to begin the 7th chapter of Bhagavad Gita. So I would like to begin the 7th chapter with a proper introduction. As we are aware, Bhagavad Gita consisting 18 chapters. Those 18 chapters have been divided into 3 shatkham. These three shatkams are known as Prathama Shatkam, Madhyama Shatkam, then the last portion is known as Tritiya Shatkam or Antima Shatkam. And these 3 shatkams, all these 6 chapters of each shatka, it deals with a particular subject. Each Shatka deals with a specific subject of Mahavakya. The first subject is called Tvam Padartha Visheshaha, which is dealt with the first 6 chapters. Then the next 6 chapters, the subject matter is Tat Padartha, means completely about God concept. And finally, these 6 chapters will deal with Asi Padartha, that is equation portion. And there were main topic in the first 6 chapter. Only 3 topics were dealt. Jiva was the main topic, then the Karma Yoga, and finally Swaprayatnam or Purusha Prayatnam or Atma Prayatnam. These 3 topics were dealt in the last 6 chapter. Jiva means an individual consciousness, and all the verses throughout the 6 chapters, you can see wherever there is a Jiva topic, it specifies Jiva is nothing but Satchid Ananda Swarupam. He is eternal entity. Then Karma Yoga. Karma Yoga means a proper action with proper attitude. Then finally, also these 6 chapters dealt with the glory of self-effort as an individual effort. Usually, other people, you know, other country people, they have an idea on India. We are believing on fatalism, which is not right. They even blame your country. Still you believe on fatalism, therefore you are lagging to get improvement, which is not right, which is not correct at all. Therefore the 6th chapter, they emphasize on Purusha Prayatnam from the beginning itself. From the 2nd chapter itself, it begins to deal with Purusha Prayatnam. Wherever there is a place, Bhagavan Krishna used to say Uddhar Edatman Atmanam Natmanam Avasadayet. So he keeps on telling your effort has to be proper. But that effort must be with confident, self-confident, not with overconfident, not even with the fatalism. We give a priority in our life for our self-effort, but we don't become overconfident, I am everything, my effort alone brings everything. No, we make the effort and we don't even lean against the fatalism. We just learn the karma theory as that the cause of everything. Then we make our self-effort, and also we keep in our mind there is one more thing. This is micro aspects, there is a macro aspects. It's a microcosm, So one more subject which remains macrocosm called Ishwaraha. The God is a concept, a reality which exists other than me, which runs the world. So everything is functioned by that power called God. Therefore what? I make my own effort with confidence, not with fatalism buddhi, and with the responsibility. The fatalism means you don't own the responsibility. You will blame on your karma. So you will be hanging over your fate. Everything will be according to the fate. No. We understand the karma theory, then we make ourselves effort, not with overconfidence, with a supportive understanding about the grace of Ishvara. Now we have learnt about us completely. Our spiritual path, our spiritual activity should begin with a proper understanding about the self. Now we have completed 6th chapter. Now we know a proper understanding about physical, subtle, causal level of my own system. And in short way we can say Jivaha, Karma Yogaha, Purusha Prayatthanaha. These 3 topics were dealt in the past 6th chapter. Now from 7th onwards till 12th chapter, the contents are going to be 3. So those 3, the first one is Ishvara Swarupam. So in the previous 6th chapter we dealt with Jiva Swarupam, means the nature of individual consciousness. Now there is one more consciousness other than me, other than an individual. Every individual, they experience their consciousness, but they don't experience the consciousness other than them. Though God concept comes in between, in the 6th chapter, in the 5th chapter, but now we are going to see, or we are going to focus only on the God concept. While focusing on the God concept, the understanding about the self also, which will remain as the foundation on which I can construct more understanding about Ishvara, more understanding about the world. Now understanding about the world is a challenging job, because even we don't know how to understand ourselves. Somehow, with the help of first 6th chapter, we have understood. Still, we don't know tomorrow what will happen with my physical, my psychological, my causal level. So this is kept as a suspense. In the same way, the world which remains with lots of secrets, miracles and so many hidden variables, in order to understand the world, you have to be endowed with a proper teaching method. That's what we are endowed with, Bhagavan Krishna. He himself will give the glory of the Ishvara, the nature of the Ishvara. Not only that, the function of the Ishvara. In the Vesti level, in an individual level, we saw the previous chapters. Now it is Samashti. Samashti means collective level. Now you have to have a broad mind, open mind to understand the things. If you have a framed mind regarding the concept of the God, you cannot understand Bhagavad Gita thoroughly. So when you learn about Ishvara, you should be endowed with a open mind, a mind which doesn't have the frame, because he is vast. So Ishvara Swarupam, Ishvara's glory, Ishvara's function, that's what known as Ishvara Swarupam. Then the second topic is going to be Bhaktihi. In the previous 6th chapter, the second topic was karma. The connection with me and my body was karma. Now, the connection with Ishvara, you can get through one is known as Upasana. That Upasana, which is known as meditation in the 6th chapter, now it is known as Bhaktihi. So bhakti is the bridge you can construct with Ishvara. So the bhakti has to be cleared. What is bhakti? Mere the emotional things or only intellectual things or mere following some vratas? What exactly the bhakti is? So when there is an understanding of Ishvara, that understanding must be packed with upasana or bhakti. So why should I understand about the God? It is said, you know, when Swami Vivekananda met Swami Ramakrishna, he asked, you know, do you see the God? He said, yes, of course I see the God. So we cannot ask, because Ramakrishna Paramahamsa has answered. So how you see the God? You have to come along with me. You have to be with me. I will make you to see the God. That's what the next answer. In the same way, you need to have the Guru to see the God. God is not a moon or star you can see, you know, with a little bit of effort. You should be aware completely about your system. That's what we learned in the sixth chapter. Now, the bhakti means what? And bhakti also, there are divisions. Understanding God as Saguna Brahma Upasana. Understanding God as a Nirguna Brahma Upasana. So that which we will bring one by one. Now the second topic which are going to be dealt with in the coming six chapters is known as Bhaktihi. The first is Ishvara Swarupam. Then second is Bhaktihi. Then the third topic is Ishvara Anugraham or Kripa. In the last sixth chapter, the third was Purusha Prayatanam. Now it is Ishwaranugraham. You can combine both. Life has to be combined with this both. Purusha Prayatanam, Ishwaranugraham. Then the life becomes heaven here itself. This Purusha Prayatanam that we learnt as Swaprayatana, self-effort. Now, Ishwaranugraha means the blessings of Ishvara, means God. It has to be there with you. Now, Purusha Prayatanam and Ishwaranugraham to be understood well. The grace of God. Okay. These three topics which are going to be dealt with the chapter which begins from 7 to 12. Therefore, the 12th chapter is known as Bhakti Yoga. Simply, we are at the door of 7th chapter, from where we are going to adapt the journey of understanding Ishvara. So whatever the form, as the Saguna Brahman, we are going to understand thoroughly that. Let us begin the first words. Shri Bhagavan Uvacha. Maya Saktamana Partha Yogam Yunjan Madashrayaha Asam Shayam Samagramam Yathagnyasya Sitachrunu. The first verse itself, he makes a pratignya. So clearly, Tatpada Vichara begins from these words. The first three verses are introductory verses of the seventh chapter. This seventh chapter, which is named as Jnana Vijnana Yoga, we will learn the meaning of the word in the forthcoming verses itself. Bhagavan himself, he will reveal the meaning of those topic title. Now, Shri Bhagavan Vacha, Bhagavan continues. Okay, he says, Mam Jnasyasi. Mam Samagram Jnasyasi. If you would have understood the past sixth chapter, definitely you would have got an eligibility to digest the five chapters from 1 to 5. Now you are ready for the second Shatka. In the second Shatka, when you keep yourself with the Swaprayatna and qualifications which are mentioned in the first six chapter, you will understand completely about me. That's what he said. Mam nyasyasi. Mam samagram nyasyasi. You will realize me completely. What does he mean completely? Completely means as sopadhika nirupadhika taya. As in the form or as in the beyond unform, beyond the srishti, with the srishti and beyond the srishti, saguna nirguna rupena samagram mam nyasyasi, you will be completely realized about me, the God. So me means, so whenever in the Bhagavad Gita Krishna says mam mam mam, me me me, so that me, it refers according to the context. So now there are four meanings we can understand according to the context. The first meaning, mam means as the Krishna, the son of Vasudeva. Vasudeva putraha arjunasya mitraha. Vasudeva putraha, you can understand me as the Vasudeva putraha or friend of Arjuna. Then the second meaning is Vishnuhu. Vishnu means what? We always discuss about these three things. When the creation happened, the creator and sustainer and destroyer has mentioned this Brahma, Vishnu, Lord Shiva. The second meaning goes the Vishnu who sustains the world, Sthitikarta. That also can be understood. Then the third word is Ishvaraha. The third meaning comes. Ishvaraha means this word. Actually, Ishvara means some people say Lord Shiva. Lord Shiva means he is Parameshwaraha, means Lord Shiva. But Ishvaraha, in general, it refers all the gods which are endowed with form. Saguna Brahma Ishvaraha. That Saguna Brahma means, so who is endowed with Maya and plus Brahman. This is a technical term which will be explained in this chapter alone. The Ishvara means, so who is in the form of Archavatara? There is one more technical term we can bring from Vaishnava Sampradaya. They call it Archavatara, as a Dashavata, Rama, Krishna, and Balarama, and Vamana. All these people are Archavatara Murti. And there are also specific Archavataras can be understood in different way. Then the last meaning is Nirguna Brahman. So when he refers, Mam means Nirguna Brahman means what? It's a final understanding of the God. Because as an individual, I have two systems. Physical system and subtle system and causal system. In the same way, when you analyze about the God, God also has got superficial physical system and the subtle system and causal level of system. So we have our own body. Even Ishvara has got his own Sharira. Ishvara's body is nothing but the world. That's what a proper understanding. But we are not going up to that level. We just understand Ishvara, who is with the body called Mahavishnu or Parameshwara, Lord Ganesha. So all these forms are given for us to understand in simple way so that we can get connected with those Ishvaras. Okay? He says, so he will be informed properly. When I complete the sixth chapter, you will be thorough about me. About me means what? You are already thorough about me as your friend. And you will be thorough as me as a Vishnu, Sthiti Devata. And you will also understand me as a Saguna Brahman and Nirguna Brahman. In fact, meditation, when you do on Saguna Brahman, it's known as Upasana. When you do on Nirguna Brahman, known as Nididhyasana. So this chapter, I'm bringing all the technical terms so that you could hear something, but don't get confused. Everything will be elaborated by the Krishna himself. And also, he continues, Asamsayam Nyasyasi. You will definitely will understand without any doubt. Asamshayam mam samagram mam nyasyasi. You will realize me without any doubt means what? The confident being an acharya, he gives a self advertisement. So don't worry, I will take care of your all understanding problems. You will understand. That's my duty to remove all the doubts. Will you get that kind of gurus? It's very rare. So all the definition about guru will be very much suitable to Lord Krishna. With every words, with the compassion towards Arjuna, the compassion towards all the creatures. When you are able to identify Arjuna, you can feel that flourishing or pouring anugraha kripa of Lord Krishna. Now he says, doubtlessly, therefore, you know, you should be endowed with guru. That's the message, you know. When you understand about yourself, so that time itself you need a guru means, so when you are about to, or you are initiating to understand Lord, means God, which is not visible completely. And he confirms that you will understand the God which visible form and non-visible form. That doubts won't be there. But you should follow what I give as a condition. So there are two conditions. So these two conditions, you have to be with a mind. Maya Sakta Manaha means with a mind committed to me, with a desire to know me. So you should be with a desire to know as the Ishvara. Then alone the teaching will work. So the God has to be fixed as the destination. Now you can understand, you know, so why should I understand the God in our life? So there is no difference between God and moksha, both are identical. Therefore, we always say, you know, I should know the God, I should reach the God. I should reach the God means I should know the God. By knowing, you will reach the God. So our forefathers, they had the language, one should know the God, one should reach the God. Jivatma should reach the Paramatma means Jivatma should understand, should realize the Paramatma. That realization itself will help to reach, and the Paramatma and the Moksha are not different things, both are identical. Therefore, what? Selecting Paramatma, God itself, is equal to selecting Moksha as the final destination. So Maya Sakta Manaha means you should be interested, otherwise you won't get connected with the subject matter. You should be interested in me. In me means what? As Saguna, as Nirguna, doesn't matter. Like Ramakrishna, I should have the Kali Darshan. He became mad about it. Finally he reached. He could get the Darshan. And so many yogis, even Mahakavi Kalidasa, had the Kali Darshan. And Rama was visible to Valmiki. Even all the gods, they are ready to give Darshan if you are making proper effort. And getting Ishvara Darshan means what? The life will be settled. You need not to make effort. But you know, people leaving the God, if they want to continue their life without God concept, means what? It is like constricting a building on the space without the foundation. I tell you why I am saying this statement. So when you remove godliness from every aspects of the life, like our science, the spiritual granthas means all the scriptures say the creation is endowed with the three kinds of power. That powers are named as Brahmaji and Vishnu, Shiva. But people say that the world is endowed with three kinds of power. Atom, when you break the atom, a small atom, it is divided as electron, proton, neutron. So naming them, so as the dead material, it is equal to get away from the Ishvara. So when you bring Ishvara into every invention, every object, then you could reach, you could communicate with that. Even medical science, when they operate, they see heart is as an instrument. So they connect all the walls to the heart, heart functions. So this is like a mechanic. Are you a mechanic of a human body? That should not be the mentality. But I have seen many doctors, they believe in God, they accept everything is nothing but God. So if you have that understanding, you can be a successful doctor. You are not a car mechanic. So that's the attitude. If even car mechanic, if he has a proper attitude, he can be a best car mechanic. The world is alive. Don't convert into a dead material. When you have the perception on the body, you see it is alive. It is not dead material. Backed up by our Veda consciousness. The consciousness is very much alive. So when you see the world, Ishvara is alive. So when you see every object with the consciousness called Ishvara, then you could communicate with that entity, that object, any object. You take a small stone, you keep talking the stone, it will respond to you. Stone will respond because stone also consists of consciousness. So if you change it as a God, so that with the help of the stone, you can get connected with the total cosmic power called God. That is a beautiful method. Now realization, God, it needs a little bit more patience, but with open mind, don't get locked with some limited or crooked mind, we cannot. That's what he says. So God has to be the destination. When you select me as the destination, me as the desirable object, and the mind which is committed to me, then you can learn. And one more thing he says, with a proper surrendering. So when you surrender, so that Mada Ashrayaha, with the proper surrendering attitude, then what? Yogam Yunjan. Yogam Yunjan means all the benefit of six chapters, previous six chapters have been kept in this verse. So now you will definitely understand the concept of the God. Not only that, without any doubt, if you fulfill the condition with a proper surrendering, with a proper fixing goal as me, if you begin the journey, definitely you will understand me. So this is an attempt in order to understand the God concept. And he will bring all the topics in this. Bhagavan Krishna continuously is going to give the detailed meaning that we will continue in the next episode. Harihi Om. Shri Guru Bhyo Namo Namaha.